Dear all, in our last videos we had seen the creation of article data. Even though we didn't see it explicitly, we had seen it as a part of our testing when we create the merchandise categories. So we had seen that the material master creation is done through the transaction code MM41. In reality, it's not necessary that always the material master has to be created by a MM41 or LSMW kind of. So it can be done through the other ways also. For example, in a retail organization or any organization, the material master is not, material master creation is not done centrally. Let us say a buyer will initiate the article master creation, and it will be extended by the appropriate departments. For example, when a buyer wants to create a material, what the buyer will enter, he or she will have the details like what is the material name and what is the unit, base unit, ordering unit, and who is the purchasing group that is responsible for this buying, and from which date to which date it should be valid, season, year. Only these kind of data are needed to create or to initiate a material master creation. Once you create the core master data based on these details, you can go for extension of the materials by the appropriate departments like sales team, purchasing team, or those team which maintains the logistics data. Okay, so to process the core master data, you can go through this logistic retailing master data, article data, article, and process core master data. So before processing a core master data, you will need to define the template or the set of fields that you will need to create a core master data. So for that you have to maintain the maintenance groups. So before processing this core master data, start managing your maintenance groups. Go to the manage maintenance groups. I have already created a template or the set of fields. Okay, so we will copy this existing one. Copy node, and I'm pasting it here itself. Basic data core. So I had copied this. Now I can add or remove the fields which I might use or might not. So for example, at this moment I am not going to use the season data, so let me remove this. Okay, I am not going to maintain the weight or alternate UPC, so let me remove this also. The other things, yes, so I might use these things, so let me retain these stuffs. And when you're creating a core master data based on this, you can let this system to pre-populate the values or propose. So to do that, click the show or hide button. You will get a here data here. So this is the creation status. Let me put it in the leave it blank. Merchandise type. No, I don't want a merchandise. I want to use WRTR as my default article type. Merchandise category, I will choose it when I am creating. Article type category also I will create when I am creating. Purchase organization WW01. My default vendor WWVN01. My sales organization is WW01, distribution channel W1. I'm leaving the article blank. If there is any article which I can use as a template for copying, then I can enter it here. Else I can leave it blank. So let me save the template. WWTR, sorry. So let me save the template. Okay. How do I get these fields? Or how can I know what are all the fields I can add? You can define them in the field group and assign the fields to that field group. So that is what you see as field group assignment. To see the field group assignment, go to the customizing. Logistics General, Material Master, Retail Specific Settings, Settings for Core. Now, before that, go to Field Groups. So you have these field groups. So these field groups are nothing but the set of fields that you that are grouped together when you are creating the article master. Let me create a new one. So this is 358, is it? Okay, so 359. Okay. Field group. Save it. Once you create a group, you have to assign the fields. So the fields name from the article master, MARC hyphen, I think LF. SAG LFGSB. So this is the storage location for external procurement. So what I can do is like assign it to 359 which we had created. Okay, and you should enter the structure name and the field name. So GLGFSB. So I can copy this to my group 359. Okay. So let us not waste too much of time on this. So we have to assign the fields in the field group which we had defined, and you can use it. Okay, since all the fields are already existing, so let me not save it, let me skip it. So I am coming back to the maintenance group maintenance. Yes, so this is where I have saved. So these are all the things which I will. So my hierarchy node is 33. So now let me go to the process core master data. So what is a maintenance group? It's 33. And what is the template I have created? I have created one template, right? See, now you get the details which you need to create the basic master data. So let me put it as WW text, and let me create a single article out of it. If I give a reference data of an article, what happens is like the system will copy all the data, like your listing, purchasing, sales data, logistics stored data, logistics DC data, and POS. So without you getting into the need of maintaining those things manually, if you don't enter it here, you will be able to create the basic data or core data, after which you have to enhance this newly created core data with the other details. It can be done either through MM42 if you want to do it centrally, or you can let the each department process it by its own, either through MM42 or through the material monitor. So let me create a basic data without any article reference data. So this should be 0 for standard. There is any assortment type. If there is any assortment, I want to assign this to WWDC group. So let me say it is valid from 01012017 to 3112099, and it would be in the WWSTRGROUP 01012017 3112099. Oh, it's 2099. Okay, it should be of today's date. Okay, if there is anything else you want to, nothing much, the creation status. So you are creating the material 10054 here. So background processing started for this material 10054. Let me see what are all the data that has been created. MM43. Okay, articles. So this is the basic data that has been created. Now we have to enhance this data. So you could say there is no other fields that has been created. For some reasons, purchasing has been picked up because of the vendor data, which vendor number which we had entered at the time of sales order creation. So we have to enhance this material. So let me go to material in change mode, add all the fields. Listing 02. We got that article update error because in my field group I had maintained the RP type, replenishment requirements planning type, and availability check as mandatory. Since I had given the assortments at the time of basic data creation, system tried to create the MRC data, that is the logistics data. When it found that when it was trying to create the marcy data, certain fields are missing, it was not able to generate the marcy data. That is the error we got. But our intention is to create the basic data as of now, so which was not affected. So I had maintained the markup in AUFS condition type, so that is why it is automatically taking up. I come to logistics. So this is what I said. This is made as mandatory. The system tried to create the marcy data for the other plans which are assigned to that assortment, so that is why we got that error. So let me fill those mandatory fields. 02 supply source should be 4, that is the standard before creating purchase order, and I want to maintain the storage location tomorrow in case I want to maintain the warehouse management settings. So I'm maintaining the basic minimum required data. So supply source is 4, 02. My storage location should be 4. Okay. So now we had seen how to create the article master data by starting off with the processing core master data and then enhancing the material. So this is one way of creating the master data. You can use this functionality of processing the core master data not only in the separate transaction, even also at the time of seasonal purchase, when you are creating the purchase order or order list for the seasonal procurement, not the standard purchase order. It is the seasonal procurement purchase order. To see that, you can go to the purchasing, seasonal procurement, PO processing, order list, create. Here, when you are creating the purchase order for seasonal procurement, for example, like your fashion goods, okay. So at that time, if you find that you don't have the material master, you need not cancel the whole process and come back, create the material master and go back. Instead, you can directly create this core master data from this PO purchase order screen itself. You can come here, WWTR. So let me say WWMen. It is the generic article. Info type 0. My sales organization is WW01. I can copy an existing article, so that should be fine. So what is the article I have for 10044. Let me copy this material. So what is that we want to give? You might want to give sweaters. So what is my purchase price? My purchase price, let me say it, let it be $5, and I might want to sell it for $15. And what is the assortment I want to add it? Let me add it to assortments manually because I don't want to see that. No, here we won't get. Yes. So WWDC because since we are already copying an existing article, all the data would have been automatically populated. Supply source. So this is what purchasing. So maintain this. Let me put it as this is a core article. I can enhance it later. So order unit EA. My regular vendor is the same. So let me leave it blank. And if there is anything for sales, unity of machine rounding profile, no, let it be fine. So I am creating a new article 10055 directly at the time of seasonal purchase order creation. I need not exit that application and create this and go back to the application and complete the purchase order. Instead, so I was able to create the article master using this core functionality at the time of PO itself, PO creation itself. So the new material is 10055. I can go to the MM43 and see this variance. /MM43 55, right? I have created everything, so I'm choosing all the values. See, okay, listing is not yet done. Okay, I have the PO values, sales order values, logistics DC. Okay, POS, nothing. So only thing I have to maintain is the listing data. Okay, so let me see what are the variants it has created. I select go into this variants, variant numbers. So these are the data it has been created. So I wanted to show you how we can create the articles out of MM41. Okay, so we were introduced to this concept of core master data and how to process the core master data without going through the MM41 routine. Okay, so before I wind up this video, I would like to show you the other way of creating the materials by copying an existing material. When you are having a similar materials that are, like you might want to change only the descriptions or the purchasing conditions. Other than that, if everything is going to be the same, including the variant characteristics, you need not go through this MM41, copying through MM41 by giving the source article. You can do it the other way of copying an article. Go to retailing, master data, article, master data, article, copy, WRF-MAT copy. So I am copying this material. Okay, if I want to, while copying, if I want to maintain it as a different merchandise category, then I can explicitly maintain there. Else what I can do is, like, I just give the internal number as I'm saying, like, copy the underlying master data. When I say underlying master data, it is all about your existing assortments, existing variants, and your other purchasing and sales related data. Plant variance means, like, if you have any different data for logistics DC or stores other than the reference stores, you can also copy that. So I just fill everything and I'm going to execute it. So the system will copy the data completely. Your this data 10055 is cloned to 1056. Only difference is I have to change the description. So go to MM 10.04 to 10.056. So this is what it said. Okay, so let me say woolen gloves. Before saving, let us see what are the other data it has created. Yes, so I need not do anything here. Same here for that old material, I gave 5 euros as a price, so it has taken that also. And so this is not a change. So I'm seeing what happens if I choose a different vendor. Logistics data, everything is taken up. Logistics store also same. See, I have created another article with very least effort. Probably it took a few seconds for me to create a new material. Okay, so that's all for today. Today we had seen the alternate ways of creating the article master through processing the core master data and copying the existing material by the WRF MAT copy. Okay, we will see the other functionalities in the coming videos. Have a good day.